Today I'm in Zermatt. I have the pleasure to talk to Gerold who is the CEO of Air Zermatt. You have your big anniversary. You're celebrating your 50th anniversary. Can you, in brief, just tell me when everything began and how it came that it is such a successful enterprise, Air Zermatt?
Well, you know, on the beginning, it was important to have this access down to the main valley because Zermatt is on the end of a very narrow valley, and quite often, also 50 years ago, we were blocked, and so the need was there to have an air access down to the valley.
And then, beside being a taxi company, what it was first, it became also a rescue company.
Well, actually, it started to be directly a rescue helicopter company, and only then all these side activities, they came on, like aerial work, like filming, heli-skiing, sightseeing flights, and so on.
Okay, and today, what size can one imagine when we talk about Air Zermatt? Is it one helicopter? No, it's of course, and how many? What's the size of the whole thing you're having?
We started with one helicopter, with a jet ranger, Augusta Bell 206. Today we have 10 helicopters, two Bell 429, twin-engine helicopters, one EC-135, another twin helicopters, five squirrels, one llama, and one EC-130. So we are flying with these 10 helicopters over 5,000 hours a year.
And how many pilots you having?
We have 10 pilots engaged on a fixed base and another four on a freelance base.
And Air Zermatt also got very famous worldwide because you are, let's say, you have been inventing some rescue techniques that haven't existed before. You even have been modifying helicopters to way that you wanted them to be able to rescue people easier. So you're pretty famous. You're also training international rescue teams, military. You are doing plenty of more than this, I think.
Well, these are niches, and you know, these kind of new technologies came out of problems we had during rescue missions. So our big boss, Mr. Perrin, who founded Air Zermatt 50 years ago, he was always trying to find solutions for problems. Mm-hmm. And this is how we get better and better and try to improve the whole technology and the rescue system. And thanks to that, we have a very high level today. And we are very proud to be part of that company.
But some of the techniques you have been inventing, you are also training you're training teams from that come into Zermatt to be trained from your guys.
It's very important not only to share the good experiences, but especially the bad ones. Mm-hmm. And out of these bad experiences, we try to improve. And it was always our goal to also to show others who are interested, of course. Mm. Techniques are completely different all over the world, but the problem to 99% will remain the same. So we think that we have pretty easy solutions. Mm-hmm. And this is what we are asked for, why we do certain things on a certain matter. And we try to let's say, it's a kind of exchange of experience. Mm-hmm. Because our philosophy is also to learn from mistake of others, because you will not live long enough to make them all yourself. Mm-hmm. That's the strategy, and I think this is very important to mm-hmm. share, mm-hmm. but also to learn. Mm-hmm.
You're the chief pilot, you're the CEO of the company. Can I ask you personally how many thousands of hours you have been flying a helicopter since you started your career?
Well, I flew a lot in the earlier years. Now I'm more in the office. And
But you're still active.
Yeah, I'm still active, but not flying so much. But I'm happy the way it is. And I have flown not so many hours, but 14,000 hours I've spent in the air. And I will reach now 4,000 rescue missions.
Okay.
But it's good. It's on the end of the career, and it's nice to see young, good pilots coming behind, and it's a good way to.
Where are you sourcing those pilots? You are training them yourself, or are you just?
Yes, that's also kind of secret of success, because we are selecting pilots from our flight assistant pool. young people really willing to learn, and they have to prove as a flight assistant. They have to eat dirt, they have to go through a hard time, they have to run, they have to sweat, and only there you can see if someone is willing, first of all, and also capable, if he can support that pressure. And all of our pilots are built or grown up here inside the company, and this is also something you are very proud of.
Thank you for these insights. Last question, you said you have done 4,000 rescue missions. Do you know by coincidence the entire number of rescue missions Haley Air Zermatt has done in its career? Or since it has been...
I think we are approaching 50,000, over 50,000
rescue
missions.
So you have been rescuing 50,000 mountaineers, skiers around the area here?
Everything, yes, in the last 50 years.
So they were happy to hear the helicopter sound, the red guys coming and bringing him home.
Hope so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
For sharing this precious moments with me. It was a pleasure having you. Keep the things going, and it's good to have people like you that are passionate, and that I see you still, your eyes glowing even when you wear your glasses, your eyes are glowing. I see it and bring over this to a new generation of pilots that continue your great job. Thanks guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe on our YouTube channel, and if you like our videos, also to like our videos. Thanks.
Okay, thanks.